Coordinator with the City of Vicksburg, and this is Gertrude Young, Housing Director for the City of Vicksburg. We want to thank everyone for coming out today on this beautiful Martin Luther King Day. Thank you for taking your day and not taking it off, but taking it on. So we really appreciate everyone being here to honor the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. We're going to open with a word of prayer with Barrett Lewis, if you will come up and say a word of prayer.
Let us pray. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we just thank you, Lord, for this moment. We thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you, Lord, for all you've done. We thank you, Lord, for giving us the mind to remember all that has already been done for us all. We thank you, Lord, that we can recognize this to be a day on and not a day off. We just pray, Lord, that you just continue to give us the strength. Bless all that are here, Father. Bless the ones that want to be here but just couldn't make it. Bless the administrations and all the officials, Lord, that they'll be able to do what you would have them to do. And Lord, we thank you. You've been mighty, mighty good to us all. And we pray this prayer in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God
bless you.
Thank you. Thank you. We would like, oh, here, yes. We're waiting for the president of Alpha Phi Alpha. Did I say that right?
You said it correctly.
All right. Mr. Edward Hill. We're going to ask him to give a brief history of Dr. Martin Luther King and how his legacy has affected not only your organization, but the youth in the community and those that you are mentoring in your, what's it called again?
Project Alpha Leadership Club.
Good afternoon. As many of you may or may not know, Dr. King was a member of Alpha Phi Fraternity Incorporated, and a lot of the values and the legacy that he has passed on to us continue on with Alpha Phi Fraternity Incorporated. And today we're just here to commemorate his legacy as a civil servant and a pioneer in the civil rights movement. And some of the history that we've shared with him as being a brother of Alpha Phi Fraternity Incorporated. We thank you all for being here. And, just happy to be here on this occasion to spruce up the monument and continue it on as a monument of Dr. King's legacy. This monument was put here some probably 20 plus years ago as a dedication of this street being named after Dr. Martin Luther King. And we're here just to commemorate it as well as spruce it up and make it look appealing for the legacy of Dr. King.
Next, we'll actually have Bobby Morrow. Here we are. Hello. First, we give honor to God for a beautiful day, for Dr. King and for his legacy. When I was first asked to give this presentation, I started doing research. And in my research, I found two of the founding members of the Dr. Martin Luther King committee that put this monument in place. I want you to meet Mrs. Pastor Linda Sweezer, and then Ms. Lurleen, are you able to come a little closer? Can someone assist her in coming closer? And while she's coming closer, I want to say that this committee consisted of five individuals. It was Mrs. Lurleen Green, Ms. Linda Sweezer, Mr. Abdullah Akbar, Mr. Walton Wardell, and Mr. Lloyd Davis. The five of them joined together to actually consider some ways that they could celebrate the Dr. King holiday. which had not actually become a holiday yet. So I'm going to let you speak to them, but in January 15th, I understood that on January 15th, 1986, was the very first meeting of this committee to actually consider what we would do to honor Dr. King. So, Ms. Lurleen, what do you want to say about it?
Good morning first, and giving honor to our Lord and Savior. It's a blessing to be in the kingdom right now. I'd like to say that when we started this journey, we had a lot of oppositions, but God brought us on through. And as I look around today and I think about what has happened in Vicksburg, from Mayor Walker becoming the first black supervisor, and then becoming the first black mayor. And most assuredly all is that we have our first black president, Barack Obama.
Yes.
I don't speak too well. But that's been something that Dr. King wanted to see, and I'm certainly sure, especially about the president, that he'd be very, very proud. And the people are coming together. We still got a little ways to go, but thank God we are where we at. And now I want to thank God. God bless you. God bless the president. God bless America.
And next you'll hear from Pastor Sweezer.
Amen. I just want to say this is really an exciting time. And Lurleen and I were part of the original committee. I had just been about 4 years, graduated from college. I don't know how I found these wonderful people. I have no idea as to how the hookup happened. But Lurleen brought the folder. As a historian, she brought the folder with original pictures of when we met back in 1986. And when this street was actually changed from Oakenwood to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard, we were really excited that the street was named for him. I remember when we were broken into committees, there were just five of us, but I remember being one of the people who was committed to going to actually finding this monument. And it was, I didn't understand my role at that time, but we were working hard because we felt like it should definitely have become a national holiday. And Lloyd Davis was a workhorse, if anybody remembers him, was a man of committed talents and resources. And I remember him saying to us in our meetings that, hey, we're gonna do this, we're gonna work hard, and these are the plans. He laid out the goals and objectives, and we were his committee. He was the visionary, and we all saw the vision, because the vision had, of course, been laid by Dr. Martin Luther King himself. But we worked hard. We had a lot of meetings from 1986 to 89 before we saw this monument come into being. I remember being excited. Once the monument got placed, I felt like I had done my part. I did come, however, to some of the meetings at Spring Hill Church, which is right behind us. And we had a lot of people who were behind this effort. There were a lot of people who didn't see the vision, but there were quite a few who did. And so we had a wonderful time. And I want to say about Lurleen Green that baton was passed from Lloyd Davis to her. And she took it, because I later became a pastor, got very, very involved in doing some other things with the church world. And Lurleen and I both were on an account together for the committee. We were the ones that wrote the check. So when this monument was bought, we both signed. And I remember when I told her, I said, well, we're turning this over to you now, Lurleen. And she has done a yeoman's job of taking it in. And we're just grateful for this moment in time to be able to share that we were just on the shoulders of some great people, Welton Wardell and Akbar, and especially Lloyd Davis. I can't say enough about the work that he did and how hard he worked. So we just thank God, because this is all a part of kingdom work. So we bless God for this day and for Bobby now taking it over. And of course, the AFIA has done a great job. We found out in 1991, they took it over. After unveiling it in 89 and 1991, the Alphas took it. So our goal is to see this monument stay and see it continue to stand as Vicksburg's legacy of what we saw long before it became a national holiday.
Thank you. That's it. I hope that you gain some history. 1986, the committee met. 1989, the monument was put in place. And 1991, the Brothers of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity started maintaining the monument. Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. King was all about a dream. And today, we first of all want to thank each and every one of you all for being here. Because you could have took this day off, but you decided to work this day in honor of him. But because he had a dream, and because we got a mayor and board of aldermen that also have a dream and vision about Martin Luther King, we want to let you know that this is just the start of Martin Luther King Boulevard. Because we want him to be proud to be on this street, the name to be on this street. So what we have been doing and will continue to do is we're going to make this street one of the proud cities of Vicksburg. We have already started through our community development division, and then we'll give it over to the mayor and the aldermen. But through our community development division, we have already started working. We have a home grant where we're going to build new houses on this street, starting with that one right there. Brand new houses where they will own their own home. We have also started those houses that are on this street that are owned by the elderly and can't afford to fix it up. We have our Brothers Keepers volunteers who are working to help us paint up and fix up the elderly homes all on this street, all the way down to Old Jackson Street.
All right.
The Kilmore Hospital will be torn down, and there will be a subdivision where the people there that cannot afford to buy just yet will be able to lease to own until they can buy. We're building 40 homes at the site of Kilmore Hospital. And then on further down, there's another 7 acres we're planning to buy. Well, not bad, but the owner is working with us to build another subdivision. All these homes are going to be from $80,000 to $140,000. You will have townhouses on this street, but those houses that are already here, we're going to make sure they represent the pride of Vicksburg.
Amen.
That two-story building down there has already been bought by one of our leading physicians in the city of Vicksburg. So the pride will come back again.
Amen.
And I ask that you give our mayor and board of aldermen a thank you for really working diligently with us for hiring me and Andrew so that we can take out the vision that they have. So we're going to turn it over to the mayor and aldermen. And then I want to also say, being politically correct, we want to thank the sheriff. As always, he's here. We want to thank our police chief, Chief Armstrong, because one of the other things that we're doing is cleaning out so that people can be able to drive through again. We got signage on the street. This is a new sign. You might notice it hadn't been here before, but it is here now. And it's going to stretch out with pride. We want to thank our sisters and our first Alpha Kappa Alpha sorority. We want to thank Delta Sigma Theta. We want to thank Miss Angela Brown. And we want to thank those. Oh, where Troy? Constable Troy Kimball. He out of uniform. Thank him.
He's here to work.
Yeah, and I just want to say this. Troy Kimball had already embraced, one of the ones that has already embraced our Brothers Keepers by redoing an elderly person's home. Because these houses are done by volunteers. The money comes from those volunteers. Sheriff Pace already got a house designated to them. So if you all want to embrace it too, please just contact myself or Angela, because it's more work to do. As long as you that have the heart and are willing to do, we can do it. So we're going to turn it over to our mayor, and then our alderman, and then we'll be booked. But we also want you to know now, you're not just here for this. We're starting from down there, all the way down this street, picking up litter. But you'll find There's very little on this street. Because these people do have pride, and they love their neighborhood, and they want it just like all the other neighborhoods. So they do what they can do. So you'll find very little to pick up. Thank you.
Ms. Young, before the mayor speaks and gives the preliminary, if you will, I think most of you noticed that once the mayor speaks, there's nothing left for me to say. I'm going to let the mayor speak. Now, mayor, you know why I was doing that now. I was giving you credit. First, again, I want to thank all of you for coming out this morning. Again, we truly appreciate the effort that you all have put forth in making sure that this community continues to grow and to thrive, to be all that we want it to be. And I'm sure all of us want to live in the best, the safest, the cleanest community that we can live in. And it's all about us working together. And before, again, the mayor comes in, and I'm sure he'll fill you in on everything, I just wanted to make sure that I came to you all this morning to say thank you. We're working daily. I appreciate what Angela and Ms. Young has done, because they've worked very hard, as we knew they would. And you're going to see a difference. We can assure you of that. But this board is going to always be on the forefront of doing what is good and what is right for the city of Vicksburg. And again, I just can't thank you as a community enough. Now, Mayor, I won't have to worry about saying anything else.
Well, certainly good afternoon, and certainly thanks to Angela and Great Two Community Development Department of the City of Vicksburg for having the vision and the foresight to put this together today. And certainly thanks to the original, the founder, the people that placed this marker here. You know, part of celebrating, and all of you that are here, you know, part of celebrating Dr. Martin Luther King's birthday is a time that you can reflect and understand what really happened. I don't know if you noticed or not, but there was a garbage truck was coming when somebody was speaking. Well, that may be God, because if you know the history of Dr. Martin Luther King, he was in Memphis, Tennessee, and he was in Memphis, Tennessee talking about the garbage collector and how they wouldn't be paid and about their labor. So when you think that he's dead, in my church, he's not dead. He's just alive. So that is a reflection and a confirmation that you that are here today are in the right place.
That's right.
Because of that dumb red garbage truck. Having said that, you know, I take every year to take a portion of what Dr. Martin Luther King has said and take one of his quotes, as I may say, by Mara, a friend of mine. And the quote this year that I phrased not only for Dr. Martin Luther King, but as we reflect over into February Black History, and this quote says that the time is always right to do what is right. So your reflection here today, you're here today, is saying that you're right. And you're always right. The timing is right to have the coming together. Because, you know, I look at the sheriff and I look at everybody here, the police, a police chief that in this community. But y'all don't know how this marker really got here in this place. You see that building right there was Spring Hill Church. Mm-hmm. And out of that church where the NAACP used to meet, I was a little boy. Uh-huh. And I used to peep through the window and watch their meet in that. So that's where it came. That's where the bomb threats, that's where the threats came from, that first building right there. And they had to start moving from church to church in this community because they was trying to hide. Uh-huh. But it started right there, and that's the reason why they came here. So those folks that said to come here, you're on the right place. Now, Great Drew have done a very eloquent job of talking about what the Vicksburg Evening Post don't print about. Mm-hmm. It's what we're talking about doing. Mm-hmm. And we only been there a year and a half.
Right.
Mike and I and Willis and I, Willis, mm-hmm. only been a year and a half. But what she did know, that it was Michael Mayfield that says that if we're going to borrow $17 million, put $10 million in street pavement, we're going to start with Martin Luther King Street.
Yeah.
Michael said that. I didn't say it, he said it. And I said, it just makes sense. When we was talking about employing Angela and Great Truth, it was them that said that we want to start with Dr. Martin Luther King as a model for the whole city. So Kings, we on our way.
That's right.
The bottom, we on our way. We just got started.
Yeah.
But yet there are some that criticize us on the way.
Yeah.
But remember what Dr. Martin Luther King said. It is always right to do what's right.
Amen.
And that doesn't mean we should ignore crime in our community. You can't have our grandmothers and our mothers and our relatives crying about crime and you don't do nothing.
That's right.
And you be a part of it. And it's been said many times, you're not a part of the solution. You're not part of the problem, you ought to be part of the solution.
Yeah.
So when we talk about Dr. Martin Luther King, so let's talk about it all in its totality. Because he went 50 years ago, some 51 years ago, to Washington, D.C. to remind America that they had not made good on their promise. He came out of there with a dream.
Amen.
But he went there to tell them that he had made a promissory note. A promissory note is a promise.
Yeah.
And they was not keeping it. So your reflection here today, your representative being here today, is a reflection of what he stood for. And it's not to be done just one day on his birthday. It's to be done every day. It is always the right time to do what is right. And I see the chief, when we talk about crimes and how we get rid of crimes, that's a part of what we do. It is our job and obligation to make this community safer than we find it. Crime is no good for nobody. We should increase and improve the quality of life. And as we share Dr. Martin Luther King Day and his dream, clearly understand it. So our children, our young children, and that's what is missing, let them know. Because this is not taught in history books. They don't teach it. But this Mississippi legislature, more worrying about a teacher of the Bible. The Bible ought to be in every house. You shouldn't have to legislate a Bible into a house or into a school. What you ought to legislate is the history. The history and why we come here today. So I commend all of you that have come here today to share what I believe Dr. Martin Luther King would have been proud of.
Amen.
And that is that you keeping the dream and the commitment alive by showing here.
Amen.
And as I leave you in my Bible says, if ever there's two or three gathered, he'll be God in the midst.
Amen.
So I'm absolutely believe with the confirmation that God has struck, and Dr. Martin Luther King looked down on us, that we're in the right place, and yes, we're doing the right thing at the right time.
Amen.
God bless you. Thank you, man.
Thank you, Mayor, so very much. An echo in those sentiments that you said, Angela Brown, the Warren County Tax Assessor, will every month, Angela will bring a youth group to this area, and she's going to place some flowers. So every month, Angela will come with a youth organization, talk about the history of the monument, and replace the flowers every month. And she's going to do that on the 15th of every month, which is actually Dr. King's birthday.
All right.
So thank you for doing that. Thank you for taking the opportunity to do that and to bring youth to this monument, because a lot of kids here don't even know anything about it. And they need to know the history about it. So we appreciate you wanting to do that for the community. Thank you. Okay, so next we're going to get y'all dirty.
We're going to make one other comment, and that is the NAACP has agreed. Our plan, our other plan, is to extend out Dr. Martin Luther King's name all the way down to Cherry Street where it should be,
Amen.
As it has in the past. The board is already aware. The NAACP is going to do the petition up for us, although it's already been blessed by that block, because we already talked to them. Extend that name
very
on
good.
Down. So it's coming under community development too, but we've already got the people, and they're committed to doing it. So it's a good day.
Amen.
On this day.
Okay, I got ahead of all of y'all and dug the first hole just to make sure that thing works. Okay? So it does work.
This is something that we have been working on for a while, and it's finally going to happen. But it's going to take all of us working together, and this is a perfect day the Lord has made. And on top of that, he gave us perfect weather to work in. So how blessed we are, and look at the people. And I want to thank all the people who come out to help to do this job. And we want to say thank you, and let's keep moving forward. There's no time to move backwards. Let's go forward. God bless.